whenever we are interpreting any text, that is always been driven by three important things. That is, what is the particular meaning or the interpretation of the word is there. Second, we have discussed that why author has said. And the third, we have discussed about the when. We are trying to understand the time so that we can capable enough or grab the real meaning or real thing about the real thing about the particular text. In the last lecture, we have also started the Terence Ball approach. Terence Ball has given the textual approach. The Terence Ball has said about that to interpret any classical text, this is one of the most tricky tasks. This is one of the toughest tasks because we don't know the language of particular author. For example, the Gandhi has written the Hind Swaraj in the Gujarati language first. So if a person who don't know the Gujarati, so how the person can interpret the Gujarati language? So first is the language, mother tongue. So that is the most important task, as the Terence Ball has mentioned in his article. Apart from that, Terence Ball has also said that each word can be only known by the person who is writing. For example, you are writing the term political, it can be it may be the meaning of corrupt, it may be the meaning of whole system. So what is your meaning of the particular term is there, that is very tough to identify by the other person, second person. So in this regard, the Terence Ball has said that we can understand any particular written document or written text with the help of various school of thoughts. So in this regard, yesterday we have discussed about the Marxist approach. In the Marxist approach, we have seen that how the Marxist approach have tried to expose the truth in front of the world, that how the capitalist class is totally based on the discrimination. Why the capitalist class is rich, why other persons are the poorer. So it was the Marxist school of thought who have disclosed the truth and try to bring out the truth in front of the world. So whenever we are reading any text, we need to think, we need to see the perspective that what hidden thing the author is trying to say with this written document, with this written words. We need to read from that particular perspective. Second thing, if you can see from the Marxist perspective, is that Marxist thinker have said that in every society there is always two class. One is the haves, who is has means the person who are the owners of means of production, who are rich, who have all the facilities, and the other hand haves not, the person who are deprived, the person who are discriminated, the person who doesn't have the basic resources, basic things are necessary, things are there. So we can see that in every society there are two class segments are there. So the Marxist approach, according to the Terence Ball, Marxist approach have tried to show the two class context or two class concept. Whenever we are reading any author, we can see that the author may be trying to define that how there is two class concept is there, how the rich class is exploiting the poor person and how the poor person is being discriminated by the rich class. And in this regard, the Marxist approach have also said that that always the person, elite person, always try to capture the idea about the people, because the poor people who doesn't have the knowledge, who doesn't have the education, they hardly have the understanding capacity. So their thought process is always being captured or controlled by the elite class or by the rich class or by the capitalist class. Like I am giving you the lecture yesterday, we have discussed about that, how I am trying to convince you with the with the things. I will give the several reasons that how I am quite correct and the you are the wrong or the other person is wrong. So in this regard, the Marxist approach has also talked about free market, laissez-faire market. You can see that if any thinker is talking about the laissez-faire market, you can understand that how the person is very much supportive to the liberal approach and the person is supporting the liberal idea, and he is trying to give the what you call the survival of fittest kind of thing, that whosoever can survive, that can be the basic thing for the development. So in this regard, yesterday we have discussed about the Marxist approach. After that, we have also discussed about the totalitarian approach. In that totalitarian approach, the Terence Ball has said, there are some authors who are trying to convince you that the one power person given to the one power is the best thing. Means like the Plato. Plato has tried to establish the philosopher king. Plato has said that philosopher king can be the ideal person who can run the state, who can run the what you call the state and take the decision, because the person is well versed, well educated person, and person is very much equipped with the what you call all the activities related to the state. On the other hand, all in the Hobbes, or the we can see that Machiavelli also, that Hobbes and the Machiavelli, both of them have said that if we want to require a powerful state, then we require a kind of power given to the one individual person. The individual person can take the decision. So with these examples, the Terence Ball has tried to show that the some person you will see in the art, in the writing, in the articles, in the book, where they will try to defend and establish the totalitarian state. The power should be given to the one person rather than the establish the democracy or establish those things. And in this regard, we can see that how the Hegel have tried to use the reason, and the reason always been associated with the real. Because, for example, if I am saying that this particular person, Hitler was the good. Hitler, it was under during the Hitler period, the Germany have what you call collected the resources. Germany was the most powerful country in the world during that period of time. So during the Hitler period, the Germany had a golden era. So I can convince you, I will give the reason that will be based on the truth, that will be based on the real thing. And this thing has been said by the Hegel, that in while time of convincing you, I will give several reasons that totalitarian state is the best. But in this regard, that real and actual thing always have the relationship. That those things can always be seen from the totalitarian approach. So these are the things through which this Terence Ball has said, whenever we are reading any book, अगर हम कोई आर्टिकल, कोई बुक, कोई भी चीज पढ़ते हैं, तो उसको अगर हम देखें कि कोई व्यक्ति अगर किसी एक व्यक्ति को पावर देने की कोशिश कर रहा है, तो हमें समझना चाहिए कि वो व्यक्ति पर्सन जो राइटर है, जो ऑथर है, द पर्सन इज ट्राइंग टू गिव द पावर टू द वन पर्सन सो दैट द पावर कैन बी कंट्रोल एंड द स्टेट पावर एंड द कैन बी देयर एंड सो द पर्सन कैन गिव द सेवरल रीजंस एंड द रीजन will be not based on the idealistic, but it should be based on the actual thing. So we have seen, we have discussed about these things in the yesterday's lecture. In today's lecture, I am going to discuss you the psychoanalytic approach. The psychoanalytic approach is been basically the one person who is associated with the psychoanalytic approach is the Sigmund Freud. What does Sigmund Freud has said? Sigmund Freud has said that all our activities, for example, whatsoever the activity we do, I'm giving you the lecture and you are taking the class. This activity is based on our desire as well as the fear. So Sigmund Freud has said that whenever any author is writing anything, author is drawing any picture or the image, the writing and the image can have the two important things. The writer is writing book, it is due to the desire or it is due to the fear. So according to the Sigmund Freud, that all the person, whosoever is writer there, they always try to fulfill some certain dream, some certain what you call the dream thing. That's why the person is writing the book. For example, the Mahatma Gandhi has written the book Hind Swaraj. He had a dream that we want to make freedom to provide the Swaraj to all the single individual in this world. So Gandhi had a dream or desire was there. So whenever we are reading any author, or whenever we are trying to read any author, we need to understand what is the desire is there, what is the fear is there of any author. If we can capable enough to capture the desire and the fear, then we can easily grab the real meaning of the particular text or real meaning of the particular article or the particular book. the psychoanalytic approach has said that we need to understand the psychology of an author. Like Machiavelli wanted to make a very powerful statecraft. He was talked about that we need to create a statecraft where all the power should be there in the hands of the king, and the king can take the decision. The king can take the decision, and the king is having all the power related to the decision making thing. So we can see that how the Machiavelli was trying to establish the prince kind of person who can take the decision. What was the reason behind it? Because Machiavelli has seen during that era that democracy was not successful. The oligarchy or aristocracy was not very successful. He was talking about the prince. The prince have the quality like love and the fear. The people should love to the prince and also have the fear that if they will not follow the guidelines or the things suggested by the prince, they will feel the punishment. So the Machiavelli has talked about the fear and the punishment kind of thing. Fear and the love kind of thing should be there. So what I'm trying to say you that the psychoanalytic approach have basically talked about that whenever we are reading any text, we need to understand the psychology. We should try to understand the psychology of a writer. Then we can easily capable enough to understand the writing or the written thing of the particular author. Agar hum kisi author ko samajhna chahte hain, agar hum kisi author ki written documents ko samajhna chahte hain, hame usko sabse pehle uski mansik dasa ko samajhna padega. We need to understand what is the mental thing, mental revolution is going on inside the author. If we are capable enough to decode those interpretation, then it will be easy for the reader or to the interpreter to interpret the text in a correct manner, rather than the just putting your words in the words of the author. So this thing is been mentioned by the Terence Ball in the psychoanalytic approach. So Terence Ball ka yahi kehna tha ki har aadmi apne dream aur desire se kaam karta hai, aur ek hota hai fear. Ya to dream hoga vyakti ka ya to fear hoga, dono ke basis pe hi vyakti kaam karta. Means whenever a person work or write anything, it should always been based on the two important things. And he has said that whenever we are trying to interpret the word of particular author like Machiavelli's Plato, we need to correlate with the dream versus the truth. Or jo us samay ki jo dasa hai, we need to correlate with the dream of the Machiavelli with the current situation. What kind of situation was there? What kind of condition was there during the Machiavelli period in the Italy? So we need to understand, we need to correlate both the time and the author written the content. They should not have a kind of big difference. If there is big difference is there, it means we are not doing a correct interpretation of a particular text. So if you want to do the correct interpretation of the word, we need to understand the psychology of an author. But the psychology of author should also associate or also establish the link or the relationship with the current situation of time, current situation. It should not be very different kind of thing. For example, Gandhi has talked about the Swaraj, and if you can say that Gandhi was talking about the non-violence is the best thing. So means we can't able to say that non-violence was the only thing. Gandhi has said that non-violence can be used as a Swaraj. Swaraj can be only possible with the help of tools like the non-violence. So what I'm trying to tell you is that the Sigmund Freud, who is the major propounder or we can say that person associated with this approach, he has said that all the individual are always been driven by the desire and the fear, and we need to interpret or decode this desire and the fear, then we can capable enough or grab the real meaning of the particular text. And in this regard, the Sigmund Freud has also said that we need to correlate the dream with the real world or with the actual world. What is the actual world is there, and what kind of dream a person have seen in the with his writing. So we need to correlate. We need to correlate Gandhi's writing with the Gandhi's period. So this thing has been said by the Terence Ball in the psychoanalytic approach. The next school of thought, the next approach according to the Terence Ball is the feminist approach. द फेमिनिस्ट अप्रोच इज बेसिकली ऑल ऑफ यू हैव डन द सम ऑफ यू फ्रॉम द सोशियोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट सो यू मस्ट हैविंग नॉलेज अबाउट फेमिनिस्ट व्हाट इज द फेमिनिस्ट इज देयर फेमिनिस्ट इज अ जेंडर कॉन्सेप्ट मींस जेंडर बेस्ड कॉन्सेप्ट व्हाट इज द जेंडर एंड द सेक्स इज द बायोलॉजिकल थिंग वेयर ऑल द पर्सन आर इक्वल बाय बर्थ बट द जेंडर इज बीइंग सोशल कंस्ट्रक्टेड इट इज बीइंग कंस्ट्रक्टेड बाय द सोसाइटी इट इज बीइंग कंस्ट्रक्टेड फॉर एग्जाम्पल if you are talking about the she is a female and she can't able to do the work these statement can you can only seen of you can only think from the society angle by the biologically all human beings are four two hands and two legs there is no difference is there by biologically both the persons are equal but it is the society who have created the gap between the male and the female male are the more powerful physical power female doesn't can't able to do the thing these things have been created by the society so whenever according to the Terence Ball whenever you are writing reading the text and the reading the text related to the gender based kind of thing that how the woman discrimination is been there how the woman rights have been violated by the male person or by the society by the state if you can see in the Indian parliament only 8 to 9% MPs are the women MPs are there and most of the more than 90% MPs are male person so we can see that 50% population there is no representation from the women in the parliament so if I will make this statement it will show that how I am driven by the concept of feminist approach is not talking about that we need to segregate or differentiate the male versus female versus third gender the gender concept basically try to talk about how our society has created the disbalance or inequality between the male and the female so we need to whenever we are reading any text if any author is writing from this perspective we need to understand the person is the feminist and the person is a supporter of the feminist idea so we need to put ourselves that how this person is trying to protect the rights of the woman how the person is trying to protect the right of the third gender how the person want to stop the discrimination between the male and the female so we can capable enough to identify and we can grab the real meaning or real interpretation of the particular text if you can see the thing from the feminist approach so like Carol Pittman has done Hobbes has tried to give the power to the human being and Hobbes always talks about the power should be philosopher king should be the very powerful power is everything power is the is most important thing so if a person is giving more what you call emphasis to the power it means how the person is more more based on the what you call the patriarchal mind setup the person is driven by the male dominated mental setup so because the person is talking about the power is everything and male always associated with the power female always always associated with the less physical power so whenever according to the Terence Ball whenever we are reading any text we need to see that person is talking about the women's role women's right women's equality or the third gender equality it means we need to put them under the French approach where we can see all the things from the light of the woman's perspective that how there is a discrimination is there there is a difference is there there is a differential treatment to the woman is there so we can read the text from this way so according to the Terence Ball if you are reading anything any text so we can see from these three things in this light Terence Ball has said the feminist approach have what you call suffered through three important waves मतलब कि हम अगर महिलावादी विचारधारा को देखना चाहेंगे इफ यू कैन सी द फेमिनिस्ट अप्रोच वी कैन सी दैट देयर आर द थ्री वेव्स आर देयर द फर्स्ट वेव ऑफ द फेमिनिस्ट अप्रोच टॉक्स अबाउट द इक्वलिटी बिटवीन द मेल एंड द फीमेल जो पहली विचारधारा आती है फेमिनिस्ट अप्रोच में इफ यू रीड सम आर्टिकल देयर दे विल टॉक अबाउट द लिबर्टी टू ऑल द मेल एंड द फीमेल एंड देयर इज अ प्रोटेक्शन टू ऑल द मेल एंड द फीमेल राइट शुड बी देयर लाइक द जेएस मिल द जेएस मिल हैज सेड that we need to give equal power to all the male and the female and they should not have any kind of distinction or distribution should be there and in this regard you can see that how the J.S. Mill has talked about on liberty and the on liberty book as well as the J.S. Mill has also talked about how we can give the voting right to the women. Women participation should be there in the political decision making. So what I am talking to you is that according to the Terence Ball, the feminist approach, whenever we are writing any text, the person is talking about the female, protection and the promotion of the female or the third gender, then we need to try to put this lens while the time of reading article. So it, with the help of this article, with the help of this approach, we can capable enough easily decode the feminist thing if the author has written. The second wave where it has talked about the equality principle, that women should be treated equally, the women should be given in the political power. So the second phase, basically second approach, what you call the wave, have basically tried to see that how the equality principle should prevail between the male and the female. And the third phase is the radical feminism, where the feminist has talked about that if you want to remove the inequality between the male and the female, we need to give extra power to the female. And only after giving the extra power to the female, then we can control and protect the women, and we can overcome from all forms of the discrimination. So this thing, this approach has been basically tried to talk about this way. So according to the Terence Ball, this approach is also important, and this approach has basically tried to talk about the role of the female and the role of the society, role of the society, how the society has been constructed. And in this regard, the last approach has been said by the Stossian approach, which we have done in the before this lecture, Leo Strauss approach. So according to the Stossian approach, what Terence Ball has said, whenever we are trying to read any text, we need to go into the past, and we need to understand the past with the context, with the surrounding situation at that period of the time. Mahatma Gandhi has written the book Hind Swaraj. So if you are reading the Hind Swaraj, then we need to put ourselves into the condition of 1905, and what kind of condition was there of the world, and how there was differences were there between the male and the female. So we can see that how Mahatma Gandhi have written one letter and the article, so that he is trying to depict the image about that period of the time. Like, hame us samay jana padega, us samay ko dekhna padega, then we are capable enough to correctly interpret the word. For example, Aristotle has said that man is a political animal. So in contemporary era, aaj ke samay mein hum political ko dirty kehte hain, but during that period of the time, it meant as a good life. The means the man is a political animal means when lives in the society, social format. Man is not an individual animal. Man cannot live alone. The individual, the people always live in a society basis. So this thing has been mentioned by the Strauss. So Strauss has given more emphasis, whenever we are reading any text, we need to read the historical background. We need to understand, read the background of the author, so that we can easily capable enough to interpret the text, to interpret the things. So this thing has been said by the Leo Strauss. Okay, agar kisi ko, if there is any doubt related to the psychoanalytic approach, feminist approach and the Stossian approach, so you can ask me. Kisi student ko any doubt hai, koi query hai, koi cheez samajh mein nahi aaya hai, to aap pooch sakte ho. Any doubt, any questions? Okay, so if yahan pe I have the question to all of you. What is your view about the contemporary era, that why do we have more than 90% MPs are there related to the male, whereas only 8 to 9% MPs are the female? How do you see it? What is your reaction? कि भारत के पार्लियामेंट में, लोकसभा में केवल 91-92% मतलब कि 91-92% मेल है, पुरुष हैं, और लेस देन 90% स्त्रियां और अन्य हैं। तो हाउ डू यू सी इट, व्हाट इज योर रिएक्शन, व्हाई वी हैव दिस?
I think there are still people who think that women shouldn't enter or they are not capable of entering the political sphere. Although we have many strong women leaders, we have had many women leaders, but I think there is this notion that, you know, women don't belong here or they don't make rational decisions enough to sit in a Lok Sabha or a Rajya Sabha or even be in leader.
Okay. Good point, Anushka. You have pointed out very important thing related to our patriarchal society, that how, if you can see in the panchayat election in the schedule 10, you can see that how the panchayat election, the woman head is there, woman is taking the decision in the panchayat as a sarpanch, but all the decision are always being taken by the father, brother or the husband. They always take the decision, and the woman, the wife or the sister or the daughter, they are the only signatory. They just do the sign, and other major decision is been taken by the male person in the of the family. So with this view, with this help, we can see that how in the Lok Sabha, in the current Lok Sabha, we can say that the most of the person who are contesting the election, they are the billionaires, like wo crorepati hain first. And if you can see the such amount of the money is there with the in the hands of the women, we can't able to find it out. Means because Indian society is patriarchal society, we can see that how there is very less person who are having the property. Most of the women are willing to participate in the election, open election, and they want to go into the seats of the MP. But the such kind of our patriarchal structure is there, that patriarchal structure indirectly is not giving. For example, in our any family member is there, they are hardly being taken as a resource for the family. We always take the boy or the male is the only resource of the family, and the boy can earn the thing, the father can earn, the brother can earn the thing, but we never see that woman can also be part of this world, of women can also be in the part of this life. So if you can see the case of Indian parliament, first is the monetary term, that all the women doesn't have the money to contest the election. Second, the membership in the political party, most of the political parties are not following the step related to the 17% reservation, and democratically they have not followed. And the third, we can say that how our society, how our social setup is also like a patriarchy. It is also supporting the views of the patriarchy. So with this light, we can say that how in the Indian parliament, you can see that there is a dominance of the male person is there rather than the female person is there. It is not only about the parliament, but you can also see in the state assemblies also. So you will find same thing is there. As Christopher Jefferlett has said, that in India, that most of the person are not participating or going for the vote because they are aware about the fact there is no value of their vote. So what I am trying to talk to you is that according to the Terence Ball, if you are reading any text, then we need to understand the text, or we can understand the text only with the help of